Alright guys, this is the NASCAR iRacing Fixed Truck Series, and we are at Watkins Glen. This will probably be my last race of the season, the last track I do for the season anyway, because I'm not interested in doing another plate track. Daytona 2007 is next week, so I'm not really interested in doing that. So this will be my last race of the season in the trucks. And next season I'm hoping to do B-Class. So I may be moving up to Xfinity or B-Class. I would like to do B-Class Open, if anybody can teach me setups. So if you're pretty good at teaching people how to do their own setups, send me a private message or send me a link to where I can go to learn this stuff. Because I would like to do the Open B-Class. If I can't do Open, I will do the Fixed Series. I'm a little bit nervous here because this race is based on your oval I-rating and not your road I-rating. And I think I'm a better road racer than I am oval racer, believe it or not. But there may be guys in here that have the same oval rating as me but are 10 times faster. Although I have been in the top 2 or 3 in every practice session I've done here. But that's basically not in traffic. So how I do in traffic will be a totally different story. Hell, I may be the ringer, I don't know. We'll see how I do though. What I'm most nervous about is guys that are in here that have never done road racing or have done very few road races, and I'm worried about them plowing into me at the braking points, because I brake very early. Example for this bus stop chicane right here, I brake very, very early for it, so that I can get a better exit.
Come line up behind the six.
So, yeah, really nervous. Just hoping to stay out of trouble and not get wrecked on the first lap. I think if I can get past the first lap and get out of traffic, I think I can put it to a few guys up front. And I'm going to take it very easy going into turn one to look out for those dive bombers. And if I have to run wide to avoid them, I will. I just don't want to get wrecked. Because I feel like I have a pretty good chance here.
Lean them up real good.
And no cautions means I have to focus. So I probably won't talk much.
All right, boss man, pace cars off. Be ready. Ready, green, 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 green. Right side. You're clear him.
Seen a lot of wrecks right there. I've even done that myself, so. There's only 12 cars in here, 12 trucks, but this is the top split for this time frame, which is pretty late at night, to be honest with you. But when I get off work, I got nothing else to do, so. I am driving with a H-pattern shifter and a clutch. I do not heel toe, though. I blip. So I'm not elite, I guess. guy's got a black flag up there. He just cut the course. I think two of them do. My foot is sliding away from my pedal. I gotta take it easier, I'm starting to burn up my tires already.
Thanks, man.
Got a little bit loose back there. Don't know if you can see it. Gonna have to start braking earlier because my tires are starting to bounce. Let's not hit the wall this time. I did a ghost race here last night, getting ready for this. And it was just filled with V8 Supercar drivers. Apparently they ran this track last week. And man, they were just blowing everybody's doors off. I mean, wasn't even a competition. It was ugly. It was really ugly. Because the V8 Supercar is a monster. I'm looking for the two guys in front of me to do something silly.
Slow one in front of you. Drive through it.
There it was.
Left to go.
Boy, I'd give anything for new tires right now. I need one more position here to break even. We're halfway now. You can hear the tires sliding on the ground. As much as I'd love to pit for tires, a green flag pit stop takes way too long and it would not help me at all. Tires are getting very slick. I'm really having to slow down early now. Guy in front of me is getting away. Not a whole lot I can do about it though, honestly. Messed up that turn bad. Actually went off the track there. I'm lucky it didn't do any worse to me. Could have really messed me up. Sometimes you set a wheel off and the whole car will turn. I really feel like I'm running on ice. These trucks are not built for road courses. This is the hardest turn to make right here. And once you go over it, the car wants to flip ends. First, the car doesn't want to turn for that uphill left-hander. Then when you get over the hill and you start to turn right, then the back end wants to come around. I'm not running fast laps right now, but I'm trying to be as consistent as I can. Because I have a feeling other people are struggling too. Otherwise, the guy in front of me would have pulled much further away by now, I think.
Coming to five to go. Thank you. pit road.
Leaders in the pits? What? Why? I think I might have just got my sixth place. If the leader wrecked and had to pit, I'm not sure though. Yep, there's sixth. So this is my goal, staying sixth. I think the guy in front of me had trouble. He's closer.
Good go.
Oh, Nelly, whoa. They're also running this track in the B class this week, so pretty much the only alternative if I wanted to run ovals would be to run the Daytona in the A class, and I've had enough of plate tracks, to be honest. I may do an actual road race this week, besides this one, I mean. This one does count towards your oval license. Whoa, oh man. Getting really slick right there. Yeah, if I was to do this again, I would definitely tell myself to take it easy in the first few laps to save the tires, because the front tires are shot, and that's my fault for outbraking myself so many times. If you go back and look, you'll see that coming up to turn one, the front tires were hopping. I just tried to drive too fast this race. I think that was a problem. But I got a sixth place finish.
Slow car off to the right.
That's the top half of the field. That's checker in the top flag. Half of the field, which means I'll pick up some iRating. And it was the top split for this time frame, so I'm happy.
For whatever it's worth, man, you did a fantastic job today, bud. Really,
oh, well, thank you.
You brought your work clothes, man, and you drove your ass off.
Oh, man, thank you. Appreciate it. I'm going to drive all the way around.